Okay, we're going to pack this up for shipping. But now that I've got the strings off it, the neck has a serious back bow. We don't want to ship it like that, nor do we want to leave it like that. So what I'm going to do is we'll mark the truss rod position with a marker, and then I'll relax this, and then you'll know where to turn it back to when you get it back, so the setup isn't a waste of time. Simply line up the red dots. Now I gotta loosen it. So when you get it back, tighten the truss rod till the two red dots line up, and you should be good to go. Everything gets a layer of cling wrap, and that way, if the cling wrap is fucked with, oh, did I say a bad word? You know, like when the bubble wrap comes off and this is screwed with, you know that somebody's been in there, like a freaking customs guy. Hey, they caught Bin Laden, they killed the bastard, so maybe the packages will start to flow between Canada and the US. Okay, that's the body. So, to make sure things get places safe, there can't be any movement in the box. So, when I got this, there was movement. The guitar actually jumped out of the box, tried to. That's why I opened it upside down. It was all flopping around inside, and everything was moving in the box, and it scared the shit out of me. Got a shot of bubble wrap in the bottom there for a nice soft ride. You're getting your peanuts back. Okay, she's a sealed eunuch. Now for the sad news. I'll weigh it and measure it and get the shipping dilemma. Shipping kills all good deals. You should be able to shake the shit out of it and not hear anything flopping around inside. She's good. They can throw it off a frickin' truck. I hope not.